Hello everyone, this is Amit. Welcome to another Notepad++ tip. In this video, we'll learn how you can find and replace any text or a string in multiple files. Now, as you work on a particular project, there may be a time where you would like to find a particular string in number of files in your project. And at times, you may want to replace that with some other string. So this tip will really help you in that. So let me start with an example. I have this project and I have a number of chapters. These are all HTML files, and at some point I would like to search for a particular string and I would like to replace with something else. Okay, and so for that we need to go to search and then go to find in files, search and find in file. All right. So there are a number of features in this particular search box. It's also called find in files. And so we'll take a look at each of them one by one. So the very first is a text box to find whatever you would like to. So you can put any string in there and then you can type whatever you would like to replace it with. You don't need to fill in anything. You can search for certain things and then click on find all. The filter is basically the file extensions that you would like to search in. So let's say you are working on HTML files and there are other files in your folder, then you can basically use a wildcard. So for example, star.html or star.c or anything like that in order to narrow down your search. The next option is directory. So here is where you will specify the directory where you would like to search all the multiple files. So you can browse by clicking this three dots and specify that folder, or you may also have a list of previously used directories, right? Now, the search mode is pretty constant in any kind of a search in Notepad++. A normal is just a regular mode. Extension will extend it to the carriage returns, line feed, tabs, that kind of search in your text. And the regular expression can use the power of regular expression to search. In this case, we'll just mainly focus on normal mode. But if you are interested in regular expression search mode, I have a number of videos in my channel that you can take a look at it and learn about that. All right. Now, the next part is these checkboxes. And so let's say you are opening a particular file. So let me go ahead and open a file from that folder. So I'll go to chapter one. Okay. And then I'm going to right click and add it with Notepad++. All right. Now I can go to find, search and find in files. And now if I click on this checkbox for find in files, notice what will happen here. So when I click on this, as you can see that it is able to get the directory of that file. And so if you already have a file open that is in your project folder, then all you have to do is just check this box and then it will be able to find the string that you're looking for in that particular folder. The one below that is actually a way in which you can search recursively. Right. So, for example, if you have a folders within folders and then you have it that kind of an hierarchy in a folder. And if you would like to search all the folders, then you can check this box and that will also search not only the folder of that file, but any subfolders as well. And then if you have some hidden folders, it can also search in that. All right. So let's do some example and it'll make more sense to you. So I have this HTML file. I'm going to open a few more. So let's see these and this. Okay. And as you can see that I have a sort of footer right at the end. Let me just view this. So I'm going to go to view current file and click on Chrome and it should be able to open in a Chrome. So as you can see that I have this link right at the end. If I click on it, it just opens a YouTube. Now imagine that I would like to change this link to something else, or maybe I would like to change the name. Whether this is my name and That is the channel name, so make sure that you check my channel and all the videos. And if you like the content, please subscribe. Alright, so we are going to search for YouTube and then we are going to replace with something else. Okay, so let's do just search first. So I'm going to go here, I'm just typing youtube.com, and then this will be *.*. This is a wildcard, which means that search for every kind of file in this folder. And the directory is C projects, and I don't want to only search in the chapter 1, but entire, all the chapters, so chapter 1 to 5. And so I'm going to remove this. And so it is going to search for all those chapters for a string youtube.com. Now make sure that your search mode is set to normal, because if you have it set to regular expression, this dot actually means something different. All right, so let's keep this. And I'm going to click find all. All right, so it did not find anything. Let's see what happened. I need to click on this. As you can remember, that when I specify this particular project, there are no HTML files. I need to search in the subfolders or search recursively. So if I check this and if I click on find all, now it is able to find all those instances where this youtube.com is found. So I can see that there are 47 hits, which means that it found 47 places in the folder, in the file. Now, if I want to open those, all I have to do is just double click on that particular string and it'll open that file. So if I scroll down and let's look at maybe heading.html, and if I double click, you can see that it'll open. It will also actually select the string that we search for. So if there is a particular string that is been there in multiple location in a particular file, you can also search, or you can also double click on that particular location. All right. So, but in my case, it's just a one single entry in each of these files. So as I said, you just simply double click on it and it'll open that file. All right. So let's go back to our find in file dialog box again. And let's say I would like to change from youtube.com to google.com, for example, for a lack of better example. So I'm going to do youtube.com and I'm going to replace it with google.com. And I'm going to again search for all of these. I'm going to remove this because I don't want to search only in chapter 1, but all the other chapters as well. Now, this time, instead of using find all, I will do replace all. Now, one caution that we need to think about is, if you're working on a lot of files, this replace in all files can be dangerous if you are not sure what you're looking for. And so make sure that you have the find all first, check the results, and then use a replace all so that you don't get some unexpected behavior. All right. So in our case, we know that youtube.com, I need to change it to google.com. And so I'm going to click on replace all. And when you click on the replace in files, it will also ask you one more time that are you sure about this? And so I'm going to click on that. And it says, are you sure you want to replace all the instances in this folder? And once we say OK, it is going to go into that file. It is going to replace that string. And it is also going to save that file. All right. So I'm going to click OK. And you can see right here, it replaced 47 occurrence. If you remember, when we searched, we found 47 different location where youtube.com was there. So now you can see that it has already replaced it with google.com. So let's confirm that. So I'll open maybe chapter 5 and I'll open any of these file, and it should, oops, it's right here. Okay. And this is now, actually you can see google.com, right? And so all of the instances are changed to google.com. Well, one way to check it is simply just put it here and just like search for google.com and find all, and we should get 47 instances again, right? So that is good. We replaced in 47 files a particular string. Now we'll do one more example. Let's say I would like to put some h2 tag or heading 2 tag right after this h1 tag. As you can see that there is always this h1 tag. In fact, let's remove this, and we are going to actually add an h1 tag right after body tag, right after this. Okay, so I'll save this, and again I'll go to search, find in files, and this is what I'm going to do. I'll search for body tag. Okay, and then I'm going to do body, and now I'm going to change the search mode from normal to extended. Okay? Because I would like to search for this string and then replace it with, I'll put this particular tag, press enter, press tab, and then put h1 tag. Okay, that is what I would like to do. And so here is what I'm going to do. I'm going to say slash r, slash n, and slash t. Slash r means, I think it's a line feed or carriage return. Slash n is a line feed. And then slash t is a tab, which basically puts a tab right here. Because if I don't do that, it will put h1 tag right here. But what I want is something like this, right? Okay, so let's undo that. And then I have put the carriage return line feed and the tab. So it'll enter a new line. And I'm going to say this one is h1 tag. And I would say search, or let's say find in file features demo. All right, and closing tag. And as usual, I'm going to replace all. And we'll see how it works. I have to change the search mode to extended, right? And then I'm going to do replace all. All right. And as usual, it'll go and go into each of these file. It'll replace body tag with an H1 tag right after that. And so I'm going to replace all. Again, it is going to ask me whether I am sure what I'm trying to do. So I said yes. So click OK. And now it actually replaced this body tag with H1 tag. I'm not sure why it didn't put slash T for a tag or a tab. But let's look at the other file. Okay, so this is okay, but okay, I needed to put two tabs because it just puts one tab right here. But that's okay. Let's go back and just look for a random file. So go to chapter 3, just let's open one of these files. You can see that it actually put this heading tag right on the top. And if I open that in Notepad++, you will see that right there, this H1 tag is there. In fact, if I want to add another tab, all I have to do is just search for this. So Control C, go here. And then here is what I'm going to do. I'm going to type slash T, which is additional tab, and then the same text. And I'm going to do replace all. Are you sure? Yes. And as you can see, now it is added the tab here. And so now it looks nicely, you know, indented. And so we looked into different ways to just do search and find in all the files. And you can do find and replace. So as I said, be a little cautious when you do replace all. But this is a very powerful feature in Notepad++ that can save you a lot of time when you want to search and replace a particular string in multiple files. Now, before you guys leave, let me just open my channel page. I post new videos about Notepad++ and just a general programming trick, tips and tricks to help you make a better programmer. And so please take a look at that. Please check out all the playlist. And if you like the content, please subscribe to my channel. All right. So we just learned how you can use search and replace feature in Notepad++. If you like this video, please click on the like button, or please add any comment if you would like to if you want me to create a particular video about Notepad++ or in general any kind of videos, tutorial. All right, thank you very much.